Gladys Berejiklian attempted to soldier on today, returning to work at Optus after ICAC's bombshell findings. But as the fallout continues, momentum is gaining for ICAC reform, the current Premier repeatedly refusing to endorse the watchdog's decision to label her corrupt.
Gladys Berejiklian, former Premier, Optus executive, and now bestowed an unwanted title, corrupt politician.
How did it feel to be told that you were corrupt?
No comment. The forced smile said enough as she tries to get back to business as usual. She and her legal team have spent the night poring over the 700-page report, which lays out in excruciating detail reasons for finding her corrupt over her secret relationship with Darryl Maguire, a verdict outright rejected by Liberal allies.
Her integrity is not in question. She's not a corrupt person.
And on a trip to Dubbo, even Labor Premier Chris Minns repeatedly refused to say whether he agrees Berejiklian's conduct amounted to corruption.
You said ICAC has uncovered serious and widespread corruption in terms of Darryl Maguire. Do you think that is the case for Gladys Berejiklian as well?
Yeah, no, I'm not prepared to make that claim.
But it will be up to him to decide whether to push ahead with reforming ICAC, and there is an appetite for change. While many on Macquarie Street accept Gladys Berejiklian did the wrong thing in failing to declare her conflict of interest, they also feel her actions were not on the same level as Darryl Maguire, who was found to have abused his position to advance his get-rich-quick schemes, yet they both received the same finding of engaging in serious corrupt conduct.
When the dust settles, we may need to look at the calibration of different levels of corruption in the ICAC Act.
And there is already a review in train. The inspector who oversees ICAC will investigate why it's taken nearly 2 years to publish this report.
As for Gladys Berejiklian's legal options, tonight those close to her are urging her to take the finding to court for a judicial review. At State Parliament, Liz Daniels, Nine News.